does tesamorelin help you build muscle? Now this question begs the next question, which is, tesamorelin will not build muscle for you unless you're eating protein and you can digest the protein, and especially unless you're lifting weights. So if you're putting resistance against your muscles, you're gonna have what's called protein synthesis. But if you wanna build more muscle, this video, I'm gonna go deep into what tesamorelin does, what the clinical research has shown, why this is so effective if you are trying to build muscle and recover faster. I'm even gonna show you how it helps improve cognitive function. So by the end of the video, you'll be completely convinced whether tesamorelin is right for you or whether it's not. So let's jump in. So first of all, what is tesamorelin? It's a growth hormone releasing peptide. It was studied extensively right around 2010. And what they looked at is they had these patients who had HIV, and these patients had this immunocompromised state, and a lot of the medications they were on actually caused these patients to build these massive volumes of visceral fat, or what's called VAT, visceral adipose tissue. And so what they did is they said, we need a way that we can modulate the ability for these patients to build muscle, because that was one of the big risks that they had. And as you lose muscle mass, your insulin levels get dysregulated, so you become more diabetic and you get more inflamed. And they also found when they had all this fat built up around their organ systems, which is known as visceral fat, the liver became really cirrhotic and scarred and fibrotic. So they found that their livers just couldn't process things effectively, and they couldn't help these patients fight back. And it was like, what was worse, the disease or the treatment of the disease? And that's where peptides came in to save the day. And so what they found in these patients who were undergoing therapy for their HIV, as they compared the group that was on tesamorelin, this growth hormone releasing peptide, that's, you know, your pituitary makes growth hormone releasing peptide, and that's what allows us to sleep deep. It allows us to hold on to muscle, allows our joints to feel good. It allows us to have that youthful appearance. But as we age, it drops down very rapidly. And so what they did in the study is they took these people and they measured a marker called IGF-1. And for those of you who ran your blood labs with us, you know I'm always fixated on that, because that is your longevity and vitality metric. It's one of the most important in the body. And they found that most of these patients were testing like an 80 or 90 year old. Their IGF-1 levels were so subclinically low that it was dangerous. And a lot of them did have straight up growth hormone deficiency, not the majority of them. What the hypothesis was is, if we can increase growth hormone, can we actually help them build muscle? And then that muscle becomes more metabolically demanding, and then they can utilize fat as an energy source and a way to build more muscle. And so over the course of 6 months, they watched the what's called VAT, their visceral adipose tissue, and they saw it shrink by 15 to 20%. And this was over the course of 6 to 12 months. Over the course of 2 years, they also saw another interesting phenomenon. They found that the fibrotic livers of these patients, and some of them, their livers were up to 90% fibrotic. So a lot of damage in the filtration systems in the liver. And they found that it was reversed when they were using tesamorelin. So this was approved. Tesamorelin is known by the pharmaceutical name Agrifta. So this is an FDA approved peptide. And now there's, you know, what's called off-label prescriptions. So now our medical team writes these off-label prescriptions where you can use tesamorelin, and usually we'll stack it with another peptide called ipamorelin. And the reason being is because ipamorelin works on the ghrelin pathway and tesamorelin works more on the growth hormone releasing peptide pathway. And these in conjunction, you get a little greater of a pulse, up to 5 to 7 times more. And I've got other videos on that if you want to check them out. But the fascinating thing that happened with these HIV patients is they also gained more cognitive clarity. They felt like they could retain information better. They also noticed that they were able to build muscle much faster than they could previously. And then when you looked at the control group, a lot of them, they still had the same body composition, they weren't thriving, and they found that their blood sugar was dysregulated, they had high lipids. And so their researchers also looked at all the metabolic function in their labs, and they found that the triglycerides in the tesamorelin group came down substantially. They found that their total cholesterol came down, especially the LDL cholesterol. And they had a metabolic profile of someone who was about 10 years younger. And then when they circled back and looked at the IGF-1, remember that's the insulin-like growth factor, which is one of the workhorses for your growth hormone in your body, they found that that insulin-like growth factor dropped into more of a youthful state. So their numbers were well above 200, which was so exciting because now they had a chance to put the disease into remission without completely destroying their quality of life. And that's one of the things I love about these peptides is they have so many advanced benefits that many people don't even know about. So if you're watching this video and you're like, hey, I really like this and I have a friend of mine and I think he's got some VAT or visceral adipose tissue, then send him the video and maybe he'll find it interesting. Here's a study, and the title of the study is Effects of Tesamorelin, a Growth Hormone Releasing Factor Analog in Human Immunodeficiency Virus-Infected Patients with Excess Abdominal Fat, a pooled analysis of two multi-center double-blinded placebo-controlled phase 3 clinical trials with safety extension. And what they found on the safety profile, and some of these patients had been on tesamorelin daily up to 2 milligrams a day, which is a pretty robust dose for up to 2 years. And I know a lot of you in the comments when I've made other videos on tesamorelin, you said, oh, Regan, it's so expensive. And I can tell you the pharmaceutical, the brand name drug of tesamorelin is very expensive. I mean, it's upwards of about $3,000 a month. And that is outside of most people's budget. But if you look at getting it from a compounding pharmacy, you know, it's about 80% of the cost. Yes, it's an investment, which is why I mentioned at the beginning of the video, if you're not eating right, if you're not exercising, if you don't get protein synthesis, you're not going to build muscle. So tesamorelin, all that does is it's the catalyst. It helps activate things. So another study that we found is when you add in a myostatin inhibitor, you're going to see two pathways of muscle building improve. Because you got onto this video, you're like, how can I get bulky and build some muscle or even just have healthier muscles? Well, what they found in the study is, and there hasn't been human clinical studies, by the way, on ACE031 and tesamorelin, but I've done it myself for a couple of years and I've seen it in hundreds of my clients, and they do really well on this because ACE031 is a myostatin inhibitor, so it activates follistatin, which is one of the best pathways to building muscle. And it turns off myostatin, which is the brakes that prevents us from building muscle. So you do that as a weekly injection, and then you add in tesamorelin where you're doing it 5 days out of the week and you're taking 2 days off, which is working on the growth hormone pathway and activates mTOR. And so the real key to using the growth hormone peptides effectively is you do it in a fasted state, ideally 90 minutes after your last meal. Do it before you go to bed or do it first thing in the morning. But typically you're going to have fewer side effects if you do it right before bed, because a lot of times with some of these growth hormone peptides, it can get a little bit of flushing, especially with CJC1295, or your immune system can start looking at these protein markers and saying, what is this? But your immune system's more calm typically before you go to bed. And you got to be in a fasted state because insulin prevents it from working effectively. So the other thing is taking the 2 days off. That's important. And then making sure that you're exercising the day that you're using the peptide. If you're not exercising, you're going to just have far lower impacts from this. And if you're eating crappy food, I mean, it's really hard when you have all the seed oils in your body and when you're eating food that's ultra processed, not getting the nutrients, not getting the proteins, it's going to be almost impossible. You can't out-peptide a poor lifestyle. And so make sure you got those basics in, and then you'll just see a dramatic improvement in your deep sleep, your cognition, so many other things. There's another study. This was published in the New England Journal of Medicine, and this is called Metabolic Effects of Growth Hormone Releasing Factor. And this is another one where with the randomized controlled studies that they analyzed, they found the average person using tesamorelin had a 15% decrease in visceral adipose tissue. Now that's substantial because the visceral adipose tissue is metabolically lazy. It causes inflammation in your body, and it also blocks a lot of the signaling properties. So you have this other pathway called NNMT that gets turned on, and you just start storing fat like it's a second job, like your side hustle. So that's a really important thing. They also found that it improved muscle quality while decreasing the abdominal fat, and we call this one the fat melter peptide for obvious reasons, because tesamorelin, for those of you who are looking to increase your athleticism, build more muscle, be more flexible, sleep better, think better, and just look better, tesamorelin may be the right choice for you. The very first place you want to start is get your blood labs done. You can go to agelessfuture.com. And then I've also got a copy of my free book. It's a downloadable copy. There's a link below in the show notes, and I'll see you there.